हेलो गाइस, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट केमिस्ट्री। इट इज थर्ड यूनिट इन सीबीएसई, एपी स्टेट, तेलंगाना स्टेट बोर्ड एग्जामिनेशंस। इन मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टेट बोर्ड्स द सेम टॉपिक इज ऑल्सो इंक्लूडेड। इट इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक विथ रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ नीट, आईआईटी, जेईई, मेन्स एंड एडवांस and other board examinations, etc. Electrochemistry is a branch of science which explains the relationship between electrical energy and chemical reactions. Electrochemistry is a branch of science which explains the relationship between electrical energy and chemical reactions. That means energy may be in different forms, it can convert from one form to another form. So it may be in chemical form or in electrical form. So by through chemical reactions we can produce electricity, or with the help of electricity we can conduct chemical reactions. In this topic we are dealing with it basing on the conductance of electricity. Electricity is nothing but flow of electrons or flow of charge. Basing on the tendency of the substance, whether to allow the conductance of charge, substances are basically divided into two types. They are conductors and insulators. Conductors are the substances which allow electricity to pass through them, are said to be conductors. And insulators are those substances which resist the conductance, which will not allow to pass the conductance of charge through them. They are said to be insulators. Now again, conductors are basically divided into two types. One is metallic conductors and another one is electrolytic conductors. Metallic conductors means when metals, all metals can conduct electricity, because in metals we have a metallic bond. In metallic bond, due to the metallic bond, free electron pool is available in metallic crystals. These electrons are free to move from one end to other end, or high potential to low potential. As free electrons are available in the metallic crystals, these metals acts as a good conductors of electricity. Of course, in metals also some are very good conductors, or some are, their conductance is less extent basing on their arrangement of availability of free electrons. So metallic conductors are those conductors in which conductance of electricity is through free electrons. That's why they are also called as electronic conductors. Metallic conductors can also be called as electronic conductors. Whereas electrolytic conductors are those substances which undergone to a chemical change during the conductance is said to be electrolytic conductors. Generally, ionic substances in their fused state or in aqueous solutions, they will act as electrolytes. Similarly, acids and bases can also act as electrolytic conductors. Any substance in a fused state or in a aqueous form, if it consists of oppositely charged ions, it will act as an electrolytic conductors. These electrolytic conductors are conduct electricity with the help of ions. So electrolytic conductors can also be called as ionic conductors. Metallic conductors are called as electronic conductors, and electrolytic conductors are called as ionic conductors. In metallic conductors, conductance is through electrons, that's why they are called as electronic conductors. In electrolytic conductors, the conductance is due to ions, that's why they are called as ionic conductors. Again, the metallic conductors, basing on the magnitude of charge they allow to pass, they can be again divided into normal conductors, superconductors, purely basing on the magnitude of charge that allowed to pass through them. Here some semiconductors, some insulators which we consider as insulator, sometimes due to crystal defects it will acts as a semiconductor. So don't be confused. Some insulators sometimes due to some crystal defects they will act as semiconductors. Now electrolytic conductors are again divided into two types, because if they have more ions, free ions are available in that, it will conduct more electricity. If available ions are less, then it will conduct less electricity. Basing on this, electrolytic conductors are again divided into two types. One is strong electrolytes and other one is weak electrolyte. Strong electrolytes means the substances which conduct large quantity of electricity, strong acids, strong bases, concentrated ionic substances will considered as strong electrolytes. Similarly, we have weak electrolytes, weak acids and weak bases, because they ionize in a less extent, less number of ions are available. As less number of available, the conductance is less, because conductance is directly proportional to number of ions present in it. That's why weak acids and weak bases are considered as weak electrolytes. This is the introductory part of this. Now, in this present topic, we mainly concentrate on electrolytic conductors. Let us move to the mode of conductance of electrolytic conductors. Now let us observe the differences between metallic conductors and electrolytic conductors. Metallic conductors and electrolytic conductors. First, the metallic conductors. The conductors which will not undergone to any chemical change during the conductance of electricity are called as metallic conductors. Electrolytic conductors, the conductors which will undergone to chemical changes during the conductance of electricity are called electrolytic conductors. Second difference, the flow of electricity in metallic conductors is through flow of electrons, so they are called as electronic conductors. In electrolytic conductors, the flow of electricity is through ions, so they are called as ionic conductors. Third difference, no mass is transferred during the conductance of electricity through metallic conductors as the conductance is through electrons. In electrolytic conductors, as the conductance is through ions, the mass is transferred from one place to another place. That means masses are deposited or dissolved at respective electrodes. In metallic conductors, the resistance of conductor is due to the vibrating metal canals. In metal conductors, we have positive metal kernels are there. Because of the vibration, they make resistance to the flow of electrons. In the case of electrolytic conductors, the resistance of electrolyte is due to the interionic attractions, viscosity of solvent. Fifth difference is, the conductance decreases with increase of temperature in metallic conductors. In metallic conductors, as temperature increases, the conductance will decreases. That means resistance will increases. Whereas in electrolytic conductors, increase of temperature increases the conductance, because the dissociation of electrolyte will increases with increase of temperature, and more number of ions are available to conduct electricity. That's why increase of temperature leads to the increase of conductance of electricity in electrolytic conductors. Now let us observe the differences between metallic conductors and electrolytic conductors. Metallic conductors
and electrolytic conductors. First, the metallic conductors. The conductors which will not undergone to any chemical change during the conductance of electricity are called as metallic conductors. Electrolytic conductors. The conductors which will undergone to chemical changes during the conductance of electricity are called electrolytic conductors. Second difference, the flow of electricity in metallic conductors is through flow of electrons, so they are called as electronic conductors. In electrolytic conductors, the flow of electricity is through ions, so they are called as ionic conductors. Third difference, no mass is transferred during the conductance of electricity through metallic conductors as the conductance is through electrons. In electrolytic conductors, as the conductance is through ions, the mass is transferred from one place to another place. That means masses are deposited or dissolved at respective electrodes. In metallic conductors, the resistance of conductor is due to the vibrating metal canals. In metal conductors, we have positive metal kernels are there. Because of the vibration, they make resistance to the flow of electrons. In the case of electrolytic conductors, the resistance of electrolyte is due to the interionic attractions, viscosity of solvent. Fifth difference is, the conductance decreases with increase of temperature in metallic conductors. In metallic conductors, as temperature increases, conductance will decreases. That means resistance will increases. Whereas in electrolytic conductors, increase of temperature increases the conductance, because the dissociation of electrolyte will increases with increase of temperature, and more number of ions are available to conduct electricity. That's why increase of temperature leads to the increase of conductance of electricity in electrolytic conductors.
As we discussed earlier, electrolytic conductors will undergo to chemical changes during the conductance of electricity. The chemical reaction that takes place while electrolytic conductors conduct electricity is called as electrolysis. Now let us observe the main mechanism involved in the conductance of electricity by an electrolytic conductor. The chemical reaction which takes place during the conductance of electricity through an electrolyte is called as electrolysis. The setup or arrangement in which the electrolysis will take place is said to be an electrolytic cell. This is a rectangular container or flask which consists of an electrolyte. Electrolyte means any ionic substances in fused state or in aqueous solution. Now let us take fused NaCl here, fused sodium chloride solution. Now I am immersing two platinum rods. These two rods will supply external EMF which is received from an external battery. Here these rods are metal rods, whatever the metal, not only platinum, any conducting metal can be used as a electrode. Either graphite can also be taken, but later we discuss the type of electrodes which are going to be used. So any metal can be used for this present instant. Now these electrodes are metal rods. One is connected to positive and other one connected to negative. The positive electrode is called as anode. Negative electrode is called as cathode. This is external EMF from which electrical energy will be produced or supplied to the electrolytic cell. Now, before applying the external EMF, NaCl, which is in fused state, it ionized as Na plus and Cl minus ions. Remember, when it is in solid state, NaCl cannot conduct electricity. But when it was heated to high temperatures, the solid NaCl will convert it into a liquid form. That is called as fused NaCl. Or if you dissolve NaCl in water, then that is said to be aqueous solution of NaCl. In aqueous state also, sodium chloride can conduct electricity. Remember, NaCl cannot conduct electricity in its solid state, because in solid state, ions are at fixed positions. They cannot move from one place to other place. That's why in solid state it cannot conduct electricity. But in liquid state, or that is fused state, or in aqueous solutions, it can conduct electricity. Now, in fused state, Na plus ions dissociate as such. NaCl is dissociate as Na plus and Cl minus ions. These Na plus and Cl minus ions are free to move in all directions in the fused solution or fused liquid. Their direction is random direction. They cannot move in a single direction. Whenever the external EMF is applied, then their movement is restricted. After applying the external EMF, the movement of these oppositely charged ions will be restricted. All negative ions, that is Cl minus ions, wherever they are present in the electrolytic cell, they move towards anode. Anions move towards anode. That means negatively charged ions will move towards positively charged electrodes. Their direction, the movement direction, is restricted. Before applying external EMF, they move in a zigzag manner. But whenever the external EMF is applied, their movement is restricted to one direction, that is towards a positive electrode. Negative ions will move towards positive electrode, and positive ions, that is Na plus ions, wherever they are, they move towards negative electrode. Now, what happened when they reach the electrode? When they reach the electrode, these negative ions, that is Cl minus ions, reach anode. There they discharge two electrons and liberated as Cl2 gas. This reaction is said to be oxidation. Releasing of electron is called as oxidation. So, oxidation takes place at anode. That means here oxidation electrons will release. These electrons will move towards this battery and reaches the cathode. And this cathode is surrounded by positive ions. The negatively charged electrode is surrounded by positive ions. Now, these two Na plus ions, they take those electrons which are released from chlorine and discharged as Na. Here, Na plus ions are absorbing electrons, and this reaction is said to be reduction. So, electrolysis is simple redox reaction. Oxidation will take place at anode, and reduction will take place at cathode. Here, if you observe this battery, it will pull the electrons from anode and push towards cathode. Just like a water pump suck water from the bore well and push it to the overhead tank. In that process only this source of electricity will works. This reaction is said to be electrolysis. Again, we are going to discuss this electrolysis in detail in the later topic.